So you want to create a free website? Well, you've come to the right place. This is going to be super easy and, as the title says, free of cost. I'm Amin from Graspo and let's get started. So with this video, we'll help you to create a website like this and we'll also show you how you can design them by just using drag and drop. You don't need to have any coding language for creating this. So we're going to do this in just three parts. First part is to launch your website. So to launch your website, we're going to do three steps. So the first step is to create an account in Infinity Free. This website will help you to create a website for free. Let's go to our browser and log on to infinityfree.net. Now here, click sign up. Now fill in these details and then click create new account. Now here you can see that we need to verify our email. So let's go to our mail and click verify. And it will take you to the Infinity Free dashboard. Now here, click create account. So we have completed the first step, which is to create an account in Infinity Free. Next, let's go to the second step, which is to get the domain name of your website. Domain name is nothing but the name of your website, which helps the visitors to visit your website. So type in the domain name you want. I am going to type Technical Dude. Now since this is a free domain name, there will be an extension along with your domain name. So I am going to choose an extension from here. And then click search domain. Here you can see that the domain name is available. Now this is going to be a website domain name which visitors enter to reach our website. Now here, just create a password for your account. And then click create account. So we have successfully completed the second step, which is to get the domain name. Now here, if we click client area, here you can see that our account is getting created. Now after 5 to 10 minutes, if we click refresh, we can see that the account is created. This means our website will be live on the internet. So let's open a new tab and type the domain name we created and press enter. Here you can see that our website is now active and it shows some random ads. This is because it takes few hours for our website to be active with the new domain. It may take 1 to 2 hours for your website to be live, or in some cases it takes even more. So meanwhile, instead of waiting for this, let's go to our third step, which is to install the WordPress on our website. Now WordPress is a tool which helps us to create website easily without any coding. So let's go to this tab and click control panel. And here, click approve. Now this is our website's control panel, which helps us to install WordPress on our website. So to install WordPress, let's go here and search for Softaculous. This tool helps us to install WordPress on our website easily. So let's open this. And here you can see an option called WordPress. So let's click install. And it will take you to this page. Now here, you need to provide your website's name and title. I'm going to type in my site name and title. Now if we scroll down, here, create a username and password for your WordPress. Okay, I'm going to create my username and password. Now this details will be used to log into your WordPress later. So make sure you note down this username and password. Now if we scroll down and click install, Here you can see that the WordPress is getting installed. So we have completed the third step, which is to install the WordPress. Now if we go to a website and click refresh, here you can see that it shows the same page. This is because our website's domain name is not active till now. Now after a few hours, if we go to a website and click refresh, here you can see that a website is active. And anyone in the world can access this website using this address. Also, here you can see that there is a default WordPress theme installed on our website, which means WordPress is successfully installed on our website. Okay, so we have completed the first part of setting up our website, which is to launch your website. Next, let's go to the second part of creating website, which is to design the website. So to create our website, we are going to do four steps. The first step is to log into WordPress dashboard. So to log into WordPress dashboard, let's go to our website address and slash wp-admin and press enter. Here, it will ask you for your username and password which we created in the previous step. So let's fill in the username and password and click login. Now it will take you to this page, which is called as WordPress dashboard, which helps us to control and make changes to our website. So once you're done with the first step, let's go to the second step, which is to install a theme in WordPress. Installing theme helps us to design websites in an easier way. So to install a theme in WordPress, go to Appearances, Themes, and click Add New. Now here, search for Astra. Now here, click Install and then click Activate. Now we've completed the second step, which is to install the theme in WordPress. Next, let's go to the third step, which is to import the template. Importing template helps us to build the website faster. So to import the template, let's click this Get Started button here. Now click here. And then choose Elementor. It will take you to this page. Now here, you have plenty of templates to choose from. You can choose the template you like. I'm going to choose this template. So let's click here. And it will take you to this page. Now here, it will ask you to upload your logo. If you have a logo for your website, just click here. Now just drag and drop the logo image from your computer. You can adjust your logo size from here. Once you are done, click continue. And here you can choose the colors and font for your website. I'm going to leave it as it is. And then click continue. Now here, click submit and build. Now here you can see that our website is being created. Once this is done, here you can see that our website is created successfully. Now if we go to our website and click refresh, here you can see that our website has been successfully created. Next, let's go to our final step, which is to edit the content of our website. So to edit the content, just click Edit with Elementor. And it will take you to this page, which is called Elementor Page Builder, which helps you to edit the content of your website by using drag and drop. Now here you can see that there is this window which is called as Navigator. In Elementor, every pages are created with different sections. So this navigator helps you to scroll between the different sections of the page easily. Now let's say you want to check the second section. Just click on the second section. And you can see that you are redirected to that particular section. And now, let's try clicking the last section. Here you can see that you are redirected to the last section. Similarly, you can navigate to different sections of the page easily and edit them. Okay, now let's see how we can edit the contents one by one. So let's say you want to edit this text. You can do that by just selecting the text and type your own text you want. It's that easy. Now if we scroll down, to make it more clear, let's close this navigator for now. Okay, here you can see that there is this sample image. Now to change this, just click over this image and click here and just drag and drop the image from your computer. Here you can see that we have successfully changed the image. Similarly, let's try changing this text. You can do that by selecting and just typing the text you want. Okay, now if we scroll down, let's say you want to remove this section. You can remove that easily by just clicking this icon above the section. You can see these icons above all the sections and delete these sections according to your wish. So let's delete this section. Now let's say you want to add a new section which is similar to another existing section. You can do that by just copying the section and paste it wherever you want. So to do that, just click the plus icon. So I'm going to copy this section below and paste it here. Here you can see that a duplicate of the below section is added here. So that's how you duplicate an existing section. Okay, now let's see how you can add a new section from scratch. So to do that, just click the plus icon and click here. Now here you can see different layouts of the section from which you can choose from. So I'm going to choose this. Now here, you can add different elements from Elementor to create section. Let's say you want to add a heading. Just go to Elements and drag the heading element and drop it here. Now to add an image, just drag and drop the image element here. And you can just add the image you want from your computer like we saw before. It's that easy. Okay, so I am going to delete this for now. Now to save the changes, click update. Now if we go to our website and click refresh, here you can see that all the changes we made is added to the live site. Okay, now let's see how we can rearrange different sections easily. So to do that, let's go back to Elementor and let's open the navigator window by just clicking here. And here you can see that the navigator window appears. Now let's say you want to move a section to the end of the page. You can do that by just dragging the section you want and place it wherever you want. Here you can see that the section has been moved successfully. So now we have completed the second part, which is to design the website. Next, let's go to the final part, which is to add a new page to our website. So to add a new page, we are going to do two steps. First step is to create a new page. So to create a new page, we are going to duplicate an existing page so that the design of the page looks similar. So to duplicate the page, we're going to install a plugin. Let's go to our dashboard, go to plugins, and click add new. Here, search for a plugin called duplicate. Now we're going to use this plugin to duplicate our page. So let's install this. and activate it. Now if we go to pages and all pages, here you can see the list of all the pages. I'm going to duplicate my home page. So let's bring the mouse over the home page. And here you can see that there is an option called duplicate. So just click on it. Here you can see that a new page is created with the same name. So let's say you are creating a services page. Just rename it by clicking the quick edit option here. And typing the page name you want. I am going to type services page. And click update. There you go. We successfully created a new page with the same look of our existing page. Now to edit the content of this page, just click edit with Elementor here. And make changes like how we did before in this tutorial. Let's delete this section for this page to look different from home page. Let's go here and click on delete. Once you make the changes, click update. Okay, now if we go to our website and click refresh, here you can see that the page we created is not seen in the menu. So to add that to our menu, let's go to the final step, which is to add a new page to the menu. So to add the new page to the menu, let's go to the customize option and choose header builder and choose primary menu and then click configure menu option and it will take you to this tab. Now here, click edit. Here you can see all the items in the menu. So to add the new page we created, just click add items. And here you can see the services page which we created. So to add it to the menu, just click the plus icon. And here you can see the services page is added to the menu. And if you want to rearrange the menu, just drag and rearrange according to your wish. Once you're done, click publish. Now if we go to our website and click refresh, here you can see that the new page we created is in the menu. So we have successfully completed creating our free website. Now let me share a few cons of using this free website. This free website can be used for learning WordPress and we don't recommend to use this as your official website. This free website are super slow and it's not secure. Also, this website can be cancelled automatically if you don't have visitors. So for this, we recommend using a paid hosting. So to get the best hosting experience and great reasonable price, just go to your browser and type graspo.com/bluehost. It will take you to bluehost.com where they provide 75% discount for all the web hosting plans and this Bluehost is officially approved by WordPress. So that's it for today's video. And if you want to create a blog, make sure you watch this video. And also make sure you subscribe to this channel and share this with your friends. Thanks for watching. See you soon.